Hello students, welcome to science class. Now your exams are very near and I hope you all are learning. You all are learning properly for your exams. Now lesson number 5, acid bases and salt. You have learned earlier also, you have seen videos and all. Now in this video I am going to give you quick recap of chapter 5, acid bases and salts. So students, open your textbook page number 49. Let's begin chapter 5, acid bases and salt. So here very first point is acids. What's are acid? What about acid? So acids are sour in taste. Acids are sour in taste and acid turns blue litmus red. While bases are bitter in taste and soapy on touching. And as bases turns red litmus blue. Again, difference between acid and base. So acids are sour in taste while bases are bitter in taste. Acid turns blue litmus red and bases turns red litmus blue. Now indicators, so we cannot taste all substances, that's why some substances are there to check whether this solution is acidic or basic. So special type of substances are used to taste whether a substance is acidic or basic. These substances are known as indicators. And some naturally occurring indicators are turmeric, litmus, china rose petals, or you can say guttal, etc. So now next page number 50. So here in box, look closely to the picture. Here in one box, blue color box is there. In this box some names of acids are given and names of bases are given. And this acid or base found in which fruits or which substances? So name of acid, acetic acid, found in vinegar. Formic acid, found in ant stick. Citric acid, citrus fruits. Lactic acid, found in curd. Oxalic acid, found in spinach. Ascorbic acid, found in amla or citrus fruit. Or vitamin C also. So what is the other name of vitamin C? So you can write ascorbic acid. Tartaric acid, found in tamarind, grapes, unripe mangoes, etc. Here some name of bases also given. Calcium hydroxide, found in lime water. Ammonium hydroxide, found in window cleaner. Sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, found in soap. Magnesium hydroxide, found in milk of magnesia. So now next point is natural indicators around us. Natural indicators around us. So first natural indicator is litmus. Litmus, a natural dye. So here the most commonly used natural indicator is litmus. And remember, it is extracted from lichens. So litmus is extracted from lichens. When added to an acidic solution, it turns red. And when added to a basic solution, it turns blue. And nowadays it is available in the form of paper strip, and this paper strip is known as red litmus paper and blue litmus paper. Now page number 51. Now in page, okay, so some substances are acids and some substances are base, but what about other substances which are not acid or not base? So the solution which do not change the color of either red or blue litmus are known as neutral solution. As I told you, acid turns blue litmus paper red and bases turn red litmus paper to blue. But some substances are there which do not change the color, either red or blue. So these substances or these solutions are known as neutral solution. The solutions which do not change the color of either red or blue litmus are known as neutral solution. These substances are neither acidic nor basic. Now next page, page number 52. See now page number 52, one more indicator, natural indicator is there, that is China rose indicator. China rose indicator, and this activity also you have learned earlier. Now move to next page, page number 53. See, so China rose indicator turns acidic solution to dark pink. Remember, China rose indicator turns acidic solution to dark pink and basic solution to green. It is very important. China rose indicator turns acidic solution to dark pink and basic solution to green. Now next page, page number 54. Here one more new topic is there, that is neutralization. So as you know that acid turns blue litmus paper red and bases turn red litmus paper blue. Okay, so now what happen when we mix acid with base? So here one more indicator is there, this is phenolphthalein. So what about phenolphthalein? So when the solution is basic, phenolphthalein gives a pink color, and when the pink color, and when the solution is acidic, it remains colorless. Again, when the solution is basic, phenolphthalein gives a pink color, and when the solution is acidic, it remains colorless. Now move to next page, page number 55. So when, now as I told you that what happened when acid mix with a base. So when an acidic solution is mixed with the basic solution, what happened? Both the solution neutralize the effect of each other. What is the effect of acid? Acids are sour in taste and acid turns blue litmus paper red. This is the effect of acid. And what is the effect of base? Bases are bitter in taste and bases turn red litmus paper blue. This is the effect of bases. So when acid mix with the bases, what happen? Both the solution neutralize the effect of each other. So when an acidic solution and basic solution are mixed in suitable amount, both the acidic nature of the acid and basic nature of the base are destroyed, and the resulting solution is neither acidic nor basic. It means both the solution neutralize the effect of each other, so that the resulting solution is neither acidic nor basic. It means it will not turn red litmus paper blue and blue litmus paper red. So this is the neutralization reaction. What this is called neutralization reaction. It means in neutralization reaction, heat is produced. When you mixed acid with base, what happens? Some amount of heat is produced. And because of heat produced, it raises the temperature of the reaction also. It means in neutralization reaction, a new substance is formed. When you mix acid with base, it means so both neutralize the effect of each other and new substance is formed. And this new substance is called salt. Now you know that salt may be acidic, basic or neutral in nature. So now the definition of neutralization, again page number 55, first column. The reaction between an acid and a base is known as neutralization. Again, what is neutralization or definition of neutralization is the reaction between an acid and a base is known as neutralization. Salt and water are produced in this process with the evaluation of heat. Now, what is the reaction for neutralization? So first we take hydrochloric acid, it means HCl, plus sodium hydroxide, it means it is a base, NaOH. So the result is, as I told you, sodium chloride, it means salt, NaCl, plus water, H2O. It means that acid plus base gives salt plus water. Remember that the reaction between an acid and a base known as neutralization, salt and water are produced in this process. So what is the formula? Acid plus base gives salt plus water. Acid, it means HCl, hydrochloric acid, when mixed with a base, sodium hydroxide, NaOH, gives salt. Salt means sodium chloride, NaCl, plus water, H2O. Now our next point is neutralization in everyday life. So in an everyday life also we use this neutralization. First is indigestion. Indigestion, it means acidity. In our local language we see that our stomach contains hydrochloric acid. That you know, in second lesson only you have learned our stomach contains hydrochloric acid, and this acid only help us to digest food. But sometimes what happen, too much of acid in the stomach, and because of that too much acid causes indigestion. Indigestion, it means acidity. So sometimes indigestion is very painful only. So to relieve indigestion, we take antacid. It means antacid, milk of magnesia, or diagen tablet or diagen syrup. Why? Because that in antacid, magnesium hydroxide is there, which is a base. So this base is neutralize the effect of acid present in our stomach, and we feel relax. Now next is ant bite. Ant bite also the same. When ant bites, formic acid is there in the bites of ant bite. So when ant bite, it injects the acid, it means formic acid, into the skin, and because of that we feel that itchy skin and all. That time what we have to do, just take some baking soda which contains sodium hydrogen carbonate and apply on the skin. So this base neutralize the effect of formic acid, or we can use the calamine solution also. Now third is soil treatment. For soil treatment also, when chemical fertilizers, excessive use of chemical fertilizer, sometimes because of that soil become more acidic. So plant do not grow well when the soil is too acidic or basic. So that time, to neutralize the effect of acid or basic, it has to treated by the quick lime or calcium oxide or calcium hydroxide. And if soil is acidic, so we have soil is acidic, so it is used quick lime or calcium oxide or calcium hydroxide. If the soil is basic, so some organic matter matters also added into the soil. Why? Because organic matter releases some acids, so which neutralize the basic nature of the soil. Now next is factory waste. So you know that in factory waste it contained too much acids. So what happen if they allowed into the water bodies? Because of this, acid will kill that fish and other organism which live into the water. So that's why the factory waste are neutralized by adding some base in it before throwing into the water bodies. So students, here this lesson is over. If still you have any doubt, so you can go through that earlier videos, which videos of lesson number 5, acid bases and salt. All the best for your exam, students. Thank you. See you soon.